too bad, I wouldn't say. I mean, nothing that it set up's pretty good, to be fair. So, right, so. We get to sort of set up there. So this one on the left hand side was less of a fade and one of the better moves. And there you go, okay. So, we'll just watch these clubs go back, okay? So, straight away you can see a difference there where that club's going, yeah? Mm-hmm. This club now has gone almost like trying to hit the ball left by taking it out there, so I'm going to swing it across your body. So, how about different again? The angle of that club completely exactly vertical. That's going to be coming across the ball all day, okay? There's a good backswing. There's as far as you can go. So, as you come back to the golf ball now, you throw your hands at the golf ball here, club way across the line. Here now as you come, it's a bit long and loose, it's at the top there, but as you come back down, and where that club's coming from, that club's coming from inside there, as you come back to the golf ball, different path there, that movement there, different path altogether there with your hands, isn't it? Mm. That club and that club, if we look at that club, it's over there, as you come into hitting out, it's a bit open there, okay, and we square up later, so you've got to feel that release of that club and that squaring up of that golf club, that to you, there would be impact, I guess. That's where the club's pointed. That feels to you, excuse me, dead straight. You then got to feel it being 30 degrees left, which would be the 50 sign. What you felt was the 50 sign would actually bring it back square. So we've got to practice hitting some shots towards that 50 sign and get it going left. But I want the ball to be going more left, Peter, by more this way, not just a big swing left and the ball cutting round still left to right. Because if you just swing it way left with the path, you're encouraging the worst move more by coming over the top rather than getting some club face control. But you can only really do that club face because it's very hard to swing the club face when the club's way out there. Mm. Think about that throwing, okay? When you throw a ball, as we said, you put your right arm sort of up here above your shoulder. You wouldn't try and throw a ball from there, I would have thought. You think about where your elbow is there. You're kind of here with your right elbow. If I said hold the ball there and try and throw it, where would it go? You've got to get that elbow to get in that position. That's really the key thing. So again, in some ways, imagine you've got a ball in your hand, swing up the top with a bit of shoulder turn, okay, where you want to throw it, and then just attach your left hand to the golf club, and that's kind of how the move wants to go. Another really good sort of practice would be get a tennis racket. Get a tennis ball against the wall. Where would the racket go? You wouldn't go kind of that way with the elbow. Pull the elbow in. You just sort of swing the racket back this way, and that I think will suddenly start giving you some sort of club face. Yeah, squash is a little bit more flicky, risky. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, so you're up there with a racket. It's all that way. Exactly. It's a difference on the move. But again, if you've got a little squash racket, you can still replicate that as a tennis movement. Get a wall somewhere. Just stand there with an old tennis ball or a squash, or whatever, and just swing it kind of this way. So the movement now is, if I said to you again, it's another way to sort of think about it. If this was a mallet on the end of your golf club, okay, and you're trying to just sort of put the ball down there, you would just sort of naturally swing it kind of that way, wouldn't you? You wouldn't try and hit it that way, okay? So we've got an extension of that. So the club goes back here, which builds it. Okay, so there's the club now, point at the golf ball, keep it there, and then from there. Exactly, they're croquet, yeah. But again, it's that build up of where that club, because your path across the ball pit is all coming from that takeaway. Because when you swing that golf club back, if you keep hold of the golf club in your setup, your club goes back, elbow goes in, that's your backswing there. Now hold the club there, okay, hit the ball from there. Wait. Very tough. And even though when you look at it, you think, how the hell do I get there? But if we look at that, that's where it is. Okay, but I think a lot of that is just in your mind. If the golf ball is going over there, I do not want to swing the golf club back in this direction. I think, okay, I've got to swing it back more in this direction to start it more in that way. And that outside the line is just going out here to try to do something. But what it ends up doing is put you in a position where the golf club just can't get back to the golf ball. Yeah. Okay, so we can get that sensation. Almost think of throwing that ball. So you put your right up the top in. Nice. Now bring the golf club back down here. We can get that club face twisting around there. Okay, so we can start controlling that club. A simple drill you can practice there is get that center, bring the club back down to my hands now, get that club face back to the ball, feeling like it's going to be 30 degrees right. I felt very tense again coming in there, really close. That's wrong, obviously, okay, but that's the feeling to you that actually will be there, because you're actually here, so there's more of this motion to try and square that club face up, will actually be square, but it'll feel initially like you're doing this to the golf club, you're never near that, because your club comes to the golf ball, obviously, this way, and then it has a flick afterwards. Getting that sensation of squaring that club. Exactly, yeah. But always try to, you want to, in some way, it's a learning of the club face. Where's that club pointed, Peter? Okay? Get more club face aware. We can hit the ball a little bit straighter, okay?
Yeah.